Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise be to Jesus. I had a message to preach, but my time is limited. I will just say a few things tonight. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. How many sense the presence of God in his place? Hallelujah. Yeah. Let me tell you, this presence of God, you can take the presence of God home with you. Hallelujah. The presence of God can be in your house, in your work situation, in your environment, wherever you are. The presence of God will be so strong in whatever you're doing. Don't allow yourself to drift back to a place where you are just doing the mundane things. God is inside of you. You are carrying the ark of the presence of God. You are the temple of the Holy Spirit. Wakatakura umari mukatimako. Umari urumawuri. So, change the way you view yourself. Change the way you carry yourself. You have inside you the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. The world may not look at you like who you are supposed to be. But I want you to know heaven knows who you are. Heaven knows what he has put inside of you. So carry yourself like the Son of the Most High God. Don't sell yourself cheap. Don't just make yourself a run-of-the-mill kind of person. You're not ordinary. You are a cut of the block who's Jesus. You have the nature of God inside of you. So carry yourself differently. Don't act like the devil's cousin. That nature is not yours. Your nature is the nature of God. Take up the nature of your father. Don't just keep lying like the father of lies. That's not your portion. Don't be comfortable among the dead. That's not your portion. Even if you do, they will not accept you. You will not be like them. Because there's something inside of you that God has put that distinguishes you from the rest. I'm talking to somebody here. Awake from your slumber. Rise up and begin to recognize who God says you are and begin to operate at that level. Blessed be his holy name. Hallelujah. I want to say three things here quickly. Mr. Che, where are you? Okay. You can keep pointing. I may end up wanting to go in a fast pace. I want to say three things. We're talking about a fresh growth. We're talking about supernatural growth. Supernatural growth is when God's dimension gets into our natural lives. God's dimension comes in into our normal lives and God begins to change the way things happen and we begin to operate with a part of the nature of heaven whilst we are here on earth. The supernatural begins in the spirit. The supernatural begins in the spirit. We need to understand. You see, many of us are comfortable in the natural, but we need to rise up and begin to be comfortable in the presence of God. We need to be men and women that will feel comfortable when God is around us, rather than when we are among dead people. There are some people who are afraid to be around holy people. They're more comfortable when they are with people who are a bit devious. Watch out your associations. In this season of supernatural growth that we're talking about, fresh growth, it's important that you begin to understand that our associations matter. Holiness cannot be imparted to you, but unholiness can be imparted to you. And then it limits your ability to operate in the supernatural or to even see the supernatural. But I want to say three things from Luke chapter 16, verse 10 to 12. The principles of progress and increase that were spoken by Jesus Christ himself. If you are going to increase in this season, I want you to take hold of these three principles. I'll just read the scripture and interpret them as I speak and pull out the principles so that you see them. From verse 10 to 12, Luke chapter 16. He who is faithful in a very little thing is also faithful in much. And he who is dishonest and just in a very little thing is dishonest and unjust also in much. Principle number one. In this season of supernatural growth, of fresh growth, you need to be someone who's faithful in the little things. Be faithful in the little things. I don't know what God has put in your hand that it looks like it's little and insignificant. Vakawanda vedu kana tana zvishoma tinofunga kuti ndezvekuti tidye tife nevana vedu. Atishadi kuti Mwari asvedere pane zvinhu zvatakufunga kuti zvishoma. God uses little things. Some of you won't believe that you are going to be faithful when you get big things. But I want you to understand the principle of progress and increase is that when you have little, that's when you demonstrate your ability to be faithful. Because if you are not faithful in those little things, how can you be entrusted with big things? We're not guaranteed that when we give you big things, you will remain stable. Some of you, when you get big things, you get dizzy. So principle number one, be faithful in little things. Some of you are not making progress here in life, in this life, because you are not faithful in the little things. You're asking, Pastor, why is it God? I am speaking in tongues. I am doing all kinds of things. I am gifted. I am anointed. But you are not faithful in the little things. This is Jesus who was talking. He says, he who is faithful in little things. Let's read it again. He who is faithful in a very little thing is faithful also in much. That was Jesus. Arkuti iwewe kuvimbika kwako kuchaonekwa nokuti wakavimbika here kana akupa zvishoma. Kana une zvishoma Mwari akati tora izvozvo unopa nhingi unokwanisa kuzvita here. If you want to measure your faithfulness, measure it with little things, especially in desperate times. How faithful are you? And faithfulness also goes with dishonesty. Vakawanda kana. Unfaithfulness goes with dishonesty. Kana vakawanda zvinhu zvazvishoma kunyepa kunowanda. Kunyepa kunowanda. He who is dishonest and unjust in a very little thing is dishonest and unjust also in much. In much. You know, we have proclaimed this way here that a little one will become a thousand. A little one will become a thousand. How is the little one going to become a thousand? How is it going to become a thousand? You put it in the hands of God. You operate according to the principles of heaven. You begin to do like that widow who put it in the hand of the prophet of God. You begin to be like that young man who had two loaves and two fishes and two loaves and five loaves. It was little. Akazvisa maoko angari. He could have said, no, and this is not going to be able to do it. He could have actually. How faithful are you? So principle number one, do you want progress in your life? Be faithful in little things. I'm talking practical things. Be faithful in little things. Usanyepe. Taura chokwadi. Ita zvinhu zviri pachena. Uone kuti Mwari anoita sei. You know, people, many of us actually think that kana Mwari, kana pastor asina kundiona, then hakuna munhu andiona. You are not contending with the pastor. You are dealing with a God who's omnipresent. How many of you know God sees everything? Yeah. You need to get this into our minds as Christians, that God is the one who sees everything. That he is the one who matters. He is the one who actually understands our faithfulness. Kana wakuya wakukonfesa pamberi pamfundisi kana pamberi pamwari, hakusi kuti Mwari ari kutanga kuziva zvaunga uchiita ipapo. Vamwe tinofunga kuti Mwari ari kutotanga kuzviona. Kuti achatovhundukawo kuti ah, ko Mwari wangu ndizvo anga achiita izvi. Mwari anga achiona zvese. Everything. You can lie to us, you can lie to everybody, you can deceive anyone, everyone. But you can't deceive God. You can't deceive the devil also. Yeah, he sees everything. The devil, God's account, my demon can go and persuade back at you. Zwaur quit. Actually, I took bad to eat a zwaur quit. So, be faithful in little things. If you are going to enter into the supernatural, zvinotanga pazvinhu zvishoma. Zvinotanga pamafuta mashoma. Are we now? Hallelujah. Panotanga nechingwa nefishi dzauinadzo. Ndipo panotanga minana yatiri kutsvaga. Tisimba ramwari riratidzwe mupenyu. Second thing here. Says, therefore, if you have not been faithful in the case of the unrighteous mammon, deceitful riches, money, possessions, who will entrust to you the true riches? I'm talking about the principles of progress. If you have been unfaithful in the unrighteous mammon, saka iwewe kana uchinyepa nezvemari. Do you know, sometimes the Christian, the devil gives Christians the spirit of hoarding. Not just, mwewe badza wewe. Badza rinongo unza kwa ndiri chete. That's the spirit of mammon. Yeah. Do you know, the spirit of mammon is the only one that competes with the spirit of Christ. The spirit of mammon wants to be worshipped. If you are unfaithful in this area, the unrighteous mammon, deceitful riches, money and possessions, who will entrust you with true riches? You need to break away from the spirit of mammon. Help me to be truthful in the area of man. Do you know many Christians actually speak themselves to poverty? Yeah. Ana yomara nutandina mari.